Now it's time to do some carpentry. Like in the past, I put the French cleat system in and I designed some stuff like this, where I put all the pliers in and I put all the screwdrivers in, and actually I had all my different types of screws here, but I switched over to from the supplied plastic cases like these, which fit nicely into here, six of them in a row. I switched over to these boys, and well, I can fit that one in, but I had it on a job around the house, so now all the stuff accumulated there, of course. I also got my other tools. I need cabinets. Well, cabinet is neat, the tools are semi neat. Tenon is actually on an angle. The mortise is actually here on an angle. The other tenon is again on an angle. So now I just need to slide them in. But this is the tightest one, so that sits tight. Set this one up for a centimeter. I checked it against the other leg. That's good. Side as well. This is a quite nice Barco CS400 I've got as a combination square. It does the job well. For these finicky jobs, I dearly wish for one of these, the small ones. you know, I would like to have a small starret and maybe a big one as well, but
I'm gonna make some corn, well, it's are some kind of cornbread meets corn pancakes, and it's based on various recipes of Jess Townsend. I will link his channel down below. Well, what you need for it, you need some corn flour, wheat flour, an egg, some milk, a pinch of salt, and I use some melted butter. Well, there are various recipes for this little bread, and I combine them, try them out, and make my own version of it. And the most recipes are all by ratio, so it's not measured out. I try to give you the right measures so you can try them out as well. Okay, first you need a big bowl, and then I add in 1 cup of flour, and I measured it, it's 160 grams. So 160 grams of plain flour. And then I add in 2 cups, so 310 grams of corn flour. You want to use the ratio 1/3 flour and 2/3 corn flour. Then I add in 1 egg. I use milk in this recipe, but water is just fine. So when you don't have milk or don't want to use any milk, water is fine to use. I'm gonna mix the flour and the egg first. The butter is for you to add last. I'm gonna add in some milk. Oh, I should have measured it for you. And you have to look at the texture of your dough. It's something in between a batter and a dough. Yeah, you can use 100 milliliters of milk. And I think I'm gonna add 100 milliliters of water. I add in 200 milliliters of water. Now we'll knead it a little bit. Some recipes obvious townsets, little corn breads or corn pancakes. Use some cayenne pepper, so when you like spicy, I think you probably could add some cayenne pepper. Now I'm adding the butter. It's 50 grams of butter. This is actually quite a good dough. You see? And I'll gonna leave it for 15 minutes on the worktop. And I'm gonna clean this and then I will be back with you. And you can use any oil to bake them in. I use olive oil, but some ghee is good, sunflower oil, coconut oil, but then the taste of course will be different. And make sure your pans are oiled and hot enough to bake them. So wait until the oil is starting to bubble a little bit. Well, not bubbling, yeah, you can see that it's working. Yeah. And then lower the heat in a little bit so it will not burn too fast. And as a result, we have those cornbreads, and I'll show you the structure inside. Is this? And I think the best way is to bake them in butter, because there is butter inside, and then they will taste very nice and buttery. Now you can taste the oil, because I bake them in oil, olive oil, and that's all right as well, but I think in butter or ghee will just slightly taste better.